Some of you guys may know that I grew up working on a small little 9-hole pitch and putt golf course that my parents owned, and I really did everything on that course, and I did it from when I was pretty young, like before I was a teenager, and then all through my teenage years and through university, and I learned a lot about lawn care and gardening. But there were some things I didn't know. I didn't learn until I started studying organic gardening. And one of the things was we would get a disease on the greens called dollar spot, which is a pretty common disease on golf course greens anywhere I've ever lived. And I'd spray a pesticide, to get rid of that dollar spot. It didn't work very well because it would come back within usually a week or so. So I'd have to be spraying this thing every couple of weeks at least, And so I wish I had known then. I didn't know that there was anything wrong with pesticides back then. And eventually I started studying the organic thing, and I figured out there's a lot of reasons why we shouldn't do that. And I figured out how, now I'm at a point where I don't have pests, hardly any pests, at least none to cause me any kind of concern here in my organic garden, because I figured out how to do it. And you could call it organic gardening, but it's more than that. What often passes for organic gardening is kind of just neglect, just let everything go wild, and that's cool. I'm all for letting nature do its thing, but for my gardening goals that I talked about in the first video, that's not gonna work. And so it's more than just that kind of letting nature run its course. And it's also more than just composting, which I love composting, but a lot of people think, oh, you just pile on the compost and that's going to make you organic. It's a lot more than that. And so the next thing I want to do today is to just go into digging in the soil here. And, in the Smiling Gardener Academy, I obviously get into some pretty major soil testing, both through a lab and also just on your own learning about your soil. Today, I'm just trying to get this all done in the afternoon here, and I just want to tell you about soil in this one video. But I want to tell you a couple things you can do that, everybody skips this basic step, but if you do this, you learn a little bit about your soil, and it helps with a lot of decisions. So it's really, some people just don't want to get out there and do any work, but it's really exciting to do this step. So I hope you'll do it. So what I'm going to do here is point the camera down. Maybe I'll zoom in on that a little bit. And all I've done so far is taken the sod off, and my bed is going to be going here. So what I want to do here is I just want to learn a little bit about my soil. The first thing would be just to, maybe try to take like a third of a cup of soil and make sure it's kind of moist. Like this is, let me turn this around so I can see it here. This is already fairly moist because it's rained in the last couple days. And just start playing with it to see if you can figure out a little bit about your soil texture. So your soil texture is how much sand, silt, and clay you have in your soil. It's sort of the proportion of those things. And the fact that I can do this quite easily means to me that this is not a sandy soil, because if you've been on a beach, you know that you can't do that with sand. There's obviously some clay and or some silt in here, because both sand, clay and silt can do this. So then you can start doing kind of a ribbon test where you try to roll this thing out, there's a poor worm in there. You roll that out, see how long of a ribbon you can roll, and if it kind of stops about there, you have more of a silty soil. If it stops at maybe a couple inches, but if you can roll it out into something that's a few inches long, it's getting to be more clay, that's what this looks like it's doing, Another thing to look at is if it stains your fingers, if you kind of rub it, clay really stains your fingers. And my fingers are definitely getting stained here, so I know there's some clay in here. Whereas silt is more related to sand, it's a little more grainy. So this, there's one thing. So let's start with that. That's texture. Very useful to figure out just kind of what you have for texture. And I know here I have kind of a clayey soil. The next thing I might want to do is just start digging. I just want to know how easy is it to dig in here, What do I have going on in here? Count the earthworms too. What you might want to do is, dig off about a cubic foot of soil out, count the earthworms in there, see how many you have, see what you're starting with, because you want to usually get more. You want to have at least 10 earthworms in that square foot, more like 20 or 30 would be wonderful. I want to see how easy it is to dig in here. I want to see maybe how deep does my topsoil go? Is there a layer where it turns to be a different color? Because I want to know what I'm starting with. I want to know, because I want to improve that, right? Need to know where I start with, what I start with, so I can see if I'm improving it. I also want to look at the roots in here and see how, if the roots are healthy, see if they have these little fine root hairs, which means there's enough oxygen in the soil. I want to keep digging. You know, this is the kind of stuff people skip because it's not that fun, I guess, for most people. It's a lot of fun for me. I'm seeing, like, I've already seen 10 earthworms in here, so that's a pretty good sign. It's fairly easy to dig. I want to kind of see if there's organic matter down in here, like if it's a nice dark soil, or does it more like concrete, or is it not a nice dark color? So there are all kinds of things to look at, and it's hard to explain in one video. I'll get more into it in the academy, but this is something that you just want to start digging and seeing. And for example, with that texture, now I know that I have a clay soil. It helps me decide what kind of plants to plant. It helps, you know, I know that a clay soil is going to hold more water. And so I can apply more water. It really helps with my irrigation scheduling. I can apply more water to this at one time. Whereas if it was sandy, the sandy soil doesn't hold much water. So I have to apply less, but I have to apply it more often. Also with this clay, I know that it's going to hold more nutrients so that I can fertilize more. There's a bunch of stuff that it helps to figure out. It helps me to figure out with water, with fertility, what kind of plants to plant, all that kind of stuff. So just, I really encourage you, before you kind of do anything in your garden, is just get digging in there. And like I said, I'll talk more about this. But that is a really good first step.